In the meantime, till others join, okay? So how many of you could visit the All India Radio website? I asked you to visit All India Radio website. How many of you have visited that website?
So we currently do not have any internships.
That is fine, ma'am. Not only about internship, I wanted you all to know their objective. Yeah, working this one means what are the different units are there and on what topics they are working, how much it is relevant, what you are studying now, no? In fifth semester in this subject, Principles of Communication System, as a subject you are studying, right? In that we deal about amplitude modulation and frequency modulation, right? So how these things are related to the present scenario, because if anybody has seen their R&D, this one R&D lab, what is going on in R&D lab? Sagar?
No, sir, I didn't really go through all that.
Yeah, no, the focus is, so many things will be there because it is commercial radio broadcasting, I mean, you'll know. So you should be able to see what is R&D. We are interested in R&D, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay, sir.
So with that, you will be able to understand the progress of this technology.
Okay.
What about others? Only Sagar is saying something. What about others?
In Bangalore, they have about 14 stations. Yeah.
So you could see that.
Sir.
Yeah. Then what else you have seen? Yes, Karunya.
Yes, sir. Same thing, sir. I was just seeing the internships and
still you need to explore more, okay?
Yes, sir.
Explore more. Fine. What about Chandrika?
Yes, sir.
You could visit the All India Radio website?
Yes, sir. Like, kind of.
Yeah, what you could find from that?
Like you
told us where you can find all the frequencies in that website. Yeah. Okay, what about others? Rushank?
Yes, sir.
What have you done? Have you visited All India Radio website, man?
No, sir, I didn't visit.
Should know. Yesterday I said, right?
Yes, sir.
Before that also I said about that. Why? You will get a lot of information about the...
I'll do it today, sir.
Do it. Okay? Fine. So... Okay, let me just... I have a recap of what we have discussed in the previous class. Yeah, now it is a full screen available, na? Visible, na? My PPT?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, we have discussed about what is modulation, right? And what is the need of modulation, right? Is it possible to say any one of you what is modulation? Yes, quickly, any one of you, is it possible to say what is modulation?
So it is the modification of either the amplitude or frequency of a signal as per our requirements.
But still it is not completed, your sentence. Yes, it is the modification of the amplitude, frequency, phase of the carrier signal in accordance with the message signal. Okay. So that we call it as modulation. Okay, if I modify the amplitude of the carrier signal in accordance with the message signal, then we call it as amplitude modulation. Right? If the frequency of the carrier signal is modified in accordance with the message signal, then we call that as frequency modulation. And if the phase of the carrier signal is modified in accordance with the message signal, then we call that as a phase modulation. Okay, these are the three basic modulation techniques. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
This is a written carrier signal as what? C of t. So which is equal to AC cos of cosine of 2 pi FCT plus 5, right? So AC is the amplitude, FC is the frequency, and phi is the phase of the carrier signal. And this is the what waveform or time domain representation of the amplitude modulated signal. Okay, first waveform is the message signal. I have drawn here amplitude versus time. Okay, I have taken amplitude of the message signal as AM, that is a peak amplitude. So this is a low frequency signal, right? First one. Yeah, see, this one is the what message signal. Okay, and this one is unmodulated carrier signal. See, this unmodulated carrier signal is having constant frequency, right? Phase and amplitude. I hope you will be able to understand this now. It has constant amplitude, frequency, and phase, right? So that is why we call this as a unmodulated carrier signal. So in case of amplitude modulation, what we do, we are varying the amplitude of this carrier signal, okay, with respect to the message signal, right? See how the amplitude of the message signal is varying, no? Like that, the amplitude of the carrier signal is varying here. So that is what is written here. So this waveform is the amplitude modulated signal, okay? Right? So this one we call it as an envelope of the modulated signal, okay? And this one is the minimum amplitude, and this point is the maximum amplitude, okay? Okay, just to begin with, see, I said what I'm doing here, amplitude of the sinusoidal carrier, right, is varied in accordance with the baseband signal or message signal. So this amplitude modulator, we'll see what is this and what is the circuit used for generating this waveform, modulated signal. Okay. And to deal with the mathematical equations, okay, first we need to start with considering the sinusoidal carrier wave, okay, which is denoted as C of t. How do we express that mathematically, right? So we express the sinusoidal carrier wave mathematically like this. C of t is equal to AC cosine of 2 pi FCT. So here I have taken phase as 0, okay, just for simplicity. Let me call this as equation 1. Okay, in this, I call this AC is the amplitude of the carrier signal, and FC is the frequency of the carrier signal, right? And the message signal is denoted by M of t, okay? So what the definition of amplitude modulation says? So it is a process in which we vary the amplitude of the carrier signal, right, with respect to the message signal. That is what the definition of amplitude modulation is. And we can express the amplitude modulated wave as a function of time, okay, as a standard form like this. That is, S of t is equal to 1 plus Ka m of t times the carrier signal. See, this one is AC cosine of 2 by FCP is a carrier signal, right? So amplitude modulated signal will be what? 1 plus Ka m of t times the carrier signal. So I have rewritten that as S of t, which is equal to AC of, just I have written AC first here, then the bracket thing same, that is 1 plus Ka m of t into cosine of 2 by FCT. Okay, so let me call this as equation 2. Here, what is this Ka? Right, so this Ka is the amplitude sensitivity of the modulator, and the value of this means this sensitivity is responsible for the generation of the modulated signal. Okay, it is responsible for the generation of modulated signal, and the choosing of the value of Ka plays an important role, okay, in saying whether the amplitude modulated signal is proper or not. Okay, so to understand that, so what should be the proper value of Ka? Okay, what is the appropriate value of Ka so that I will be able to get the modulated signal proper, and I will be able to demodulate at the receiver side without any distortions. Okay, to understand that, so let me take an example, okay, with these values. That is, let us consider the amplitude of the carrier, that is AC, is equal to 1 volt, okay, and the value of the sensitivity, so which is equal to 1 by 2 I am taking, okay. So let me try for different values of Ka. So as a first value, I am taking Ka is equal to 1 by 2, and this FM, that is the frequency of the message signal, so which is equal to 1 by 2 I have taken, okay. So I am expressing the message signal, okay, m of t, as a cosine function, that is cos of, that is cosine of 2 by fmt, okay, with a magnitude of 1 here, right? So when I substitute the value of fm as 1 by 2, what happens here? The 2 will get cancelled. I will be getting m of t is equal to cosine of pi t. So this is my m of t, okay? Is it clear about the consideration of these values? Yes, I am asking, is it clear about whatever the value I have considered?
Yes,
to say,
yes, sir.
To understand, yes, sir, the importance of what? Okay, to understand the importance of what? The impact of the value of K, that is sensitivity factor, okay, in the amplitude modulated signal. So what are the values I have considered? I have taken an example with what? Amplitude of the carrier is 1 volt. Okay, the value of sensitivity, which is equal to 1 by 2 I have taken. Then the frequency of the message signal, I have considered it is 1 by 2. Right? I am considering the message signal as what? Cosine function. So which is equal to, I can define m of t is equal to cosine of 2 pi fmt, right? Now, if I substitute the value of fm as 1 by 2 in this equation, so what I get? M of t is equal to cosine of pi t, okay? So now, let me substitute all these values in this equation, okay? Right, this is my expression for amplitude modulated signal. So I'm just substituting the value of AC as 1, right? And Ka is 1 by 2. And m of t is what? Cosine of pi t. Right? Please note down this equation and substitute these values. After substituting these values, let me find out what is the maximum and minimum value of this factor. Okay, that is 1 plus 1 by 2 cosine of pi t. Okay, how do you find the maximum and minimum value of this factor? 1 plus 1 by 2 cosine of pi t, by taking cos of, that is cosine of pi t is equal to 1. So when cosine of pi t is equal to 1, what is its value, right? So cosine of pi t is 1, so I will be getting how much? It is 3 by 2. That is the maximum value. Then when cosine of pi t is equal to minus 1, right, I am getting its minimum value as what? 1 by 2. right? Because cosine of pi t is equal to minus 1. If I substitute that in this equation, it will be 1 by 2. So that is 1 minus 1 by 2. It is getting 1 by 2. Okay. So I could find out what is the maximum and minimum value of this factor. Isn't it? That is 1 plus 1 by 2 cosine of pi t. Yes, I hope is it written in your notebook, these equations and along with the values?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, shall I go to the next slide? Is completed.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'll go to the next. So what I'm doing is I'm just finding the value of this, right? 1 plus 1 by 2 cosine of pi t for different values of t. Okay, because I need to draw this waveform, right? As a modulated waveform. For that, I'm finding this at t equal to 0. When I say t equal to 0, what happens? It will be 3 by 2, right? This value. Then when t equal to 1, for this value, I will be getting it is 1 by 2. Then again at t equal to 2, so I will be getting the value of this one as 3 by 2. Again at t equal to 3, I will be getting the value of this as what? 1 by 2. And it keeps repeating, right? Once it is 1 by 2, another time it is 3 by 2. 3 by 2, 1 by 2, 3 by 2, 1 by 2, and so on, right? So what I can say is the value of this factor, 1 plus 1 by 2 cosine of pi t, varies between this range, 1 by 2 to 3 by 2. Okay. So now, let me draw this waveform. Okay. Yesterday, I asked you people to draw it. Have you drawn that? Anybody tried to draw this waveform with these values?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So I hope this picture is visible, na? So take x-axis as time. Okay, first diagram, x-axis as time. Mark it as 1, 2, 3 and so on, right? And y-axis, okay? Y-axis also you can mark it as 1, 2 and so on. So here I marked 1 by 2 and as well as 3 by 2 because I know what is the maximum and minimum value of that modulated signal amplitude, right? I'm getting one is 1 by 2, another is 3 by 2. So this is the first step what you can do. Next is what you can do is with respect to the value of t, because x-axis is t, right? I said when t equal to 0, the magnitude of that is how much I'm getting? 3 by 2. So you can mark one dot here at this point, right? At t equal to 0, this point is 0. At t equal to 0, you can put one dot here. Then at t equal to 1, how much I'm getting? I'm getting it is 1 by 2, right? You can put one dot here. Then at t equal to 2, I'm getting it is 3 by 2. So you can put one dot at this point with the respect to 3 by 2 value. Then at t equal to 3, again I am getting it is 1 by 2. So you can put 1 dot here, right, with respect to this one. I hope you have done this. After that, after doing this, what you can do, you can just join those dots, okay, like this, means which is written here, okay, fine. So similar to this, okay, you can draw the mirror image of this one, means with a negative value, right? Isn't it? That is from, it varies from what? Minus 1 by 2 to minus 3 by 2, right? So minus 1 by 2, minus 1, minus 3 by 2, minus 2 I have written. So at t equal to 0, again it will be minus 3 by 2. Then at t equal to 1, it will be minus 1 by 2. Then at t equal to 2, it is minus 3 by 2. Again at t equal to 3, it is minus 1 by 2. And you can put those dots and you can join these dots. You will get this waveform. Now what you can do after writing this, you can write the carrier wave, okay, with that. Isn't it like this? You can write the carrier wave. I hope this is done, right? So we call this as the next figure I have shown. This one is the carrier, right? Cosine of 2 pi fct. Right. So now what you're finding, the amplitude of the carrier is varying, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this reflection should come in your diagram. And what we call this one means the tips of the carrier signal. So what we got is tips of this point, no? The tips of this one. Does it resembles the shape of the message signal? M of T.
Yes, sir.
Right. So we call this as an envelope of the carrier signal. Okay. Envelope of the carrier. Yeah. Which is written here. I said this is what? Carrier. Right. This point. Cosine of 2πfct. And this one, this point, no? Whatever I have drawn the tip of this line, right? The carrier signal. That is what this value, right? 1 plus 1 by 2 cosine of πt, which we call as modulating signal. And after joining this, right? So this we call it as, what we call this one is the envelope of the carrier signal. Okay. Why this envelope of the carrier signal is important?
It carries the information, sir.
Yeah. Because see, this one we say the amplitude of the message carrier signal, right? Right. So the envelope of the carrier contains information about the message signal, right? So that is why the envelope of the carrier is very important, because at the receiver side, I need this envelope only, right? I need to extract this signal, right? So that is why I say the envelope of the carrier contains the information about the message signal. And in almost all of the communication systems, okay, we assume the carrier frequency, okay, that is known as FC, will be much greater than the frequency of the message signal. Okay. So this is the general, this one, to get a proper modulated signal, the frequency of the carrier signal has to be much, much greater than the frequency of the message signal. Okay, so far I have drawn the amplitude modulated signal, right, by taking the value of Ka as 1 by 2, right? Now I will take another value of Ka, okay? So let me take the value of Ka as 3 by 2, okay? Means in the earlier this one, I have taken K as 1 by 2, right? So now I have higher value, K is equal to 3 by 2. So by taking Ka as 3 by 2 and the rest of the values are same, that is AC is equal to 1, FM is equal to 1 by 2, you can calculate what is the maximum and minimum value of this one. That is 1 plus Ka M of T. So just as of here, 1 plus K as 1 by, that is 3 by 2.
Right? Sir. Sir, I have a doubt in previous slide.
Yeah, what doubt do you have, man? Yes, please.
No, sir, you when you plotted the envelope of the carrier,
yeah.
When T is 1, it will be half, no, sir?
Yeah, half, yeah, that is what I have shown, half only.
So then why have you
plotted? See, at T 1, it is half only. At this point, I put a dot and I have written, yeah.
So why have we even plotted in the negative axis, sir?
Why it is drawn in the negative axis, right? See, carrier signal is having both positive amplitude and as well as negative amplitude, right?
Yeah.
So that is why I have taken mirror image of this. Only for positive, yes, you can consider only above part. Only if I have a carrier signal with respect to this, only zero reference line. But I have a carrier signal which is having positive amplitude and as well as negative amplitude. That is why I taken for drawing this envelope, no? Positive envelope, right? For this thing, I taken AC is equal to 1. Okay. To draw this one, no? You need to take AC is equal to minus 1.
Okay, got it.
Yeah. That is why I'm saying just mirror image of this. If you take AC is equal to minus 1, rest of the things you will get as minus 1 by 2 and minus 3 by 2. With that, you will be able to write this waveform. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Please substitute AC is equal to minus 1 by 2 and K is 1 by 2 and FM is 1 by 2. Right. Anyway, M of T will not change. It will be cosine of pi T only. And if you substitute those values, you will be able to see whether at t equal to 0, you are getting minus 3 by 2 or not. And at t equal to 1, you are getting minus 1 by 2 or not. And so on. Are you getting at t equal to 0 as minus 3 by 2? See, when AC is minus 1, what happens when in this equation? This becomes what? Minus 1, minus 1 by 2, right? You need to multiply with minus 1, no?
Yeah, sir.
I think that much you will be able to do that, right?
Yeah, sir.
You got that point clear?
Yes, sir.
So now, shall I go to the next one?
Yes, sir. 3 by 2.
Yeah, you do. You all should do by yourself by taking the value of K as 3 by 2. We have already shown the calculation. Okay. What is the maximum minimum value? You do it by yourself and tell me whether you are getting the maximum value as 5 by 2 and minimum value as minus 1 by 2. And similarly, how we have found for t equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, no? Similar to that, you find out for this also and try to draw the graph. And any one of you can show from your camera.
Sir, only K value changes, sir.
Yeah, only I have changed the K value. K from so 1 by 2.
F will be 1 by 2, no, sir? And AC will be 1.
Yeah, AC will be 1. Yes, everyone should do. I will ask randomly to show from your camera. Yes, Siddharth. Yes, anybody could complete? Can you show from your...
So they look like pulses.
Huh?
They look like pulses. So there are...
No, no, it won't look like a pulses. Yeah, you draw the envelope, man. Just you draw the envelope.
So the maximum value is 5 by 2, right?
Ah, yeah, maximum value is 5 by 2. Minimum is how much? Minus 1 by 2, no?
Minus 1 by 2, sir.
Yeah, you have to draw, and even with your previous example.
Okay.
As you know, it repeats, right? When t equal to 0, it will be 5 by 2. When t equal to 1, it will be?
Minus 1 by 2.
By 2. And similarly, at t is equal to 2, it will be again 5 by 2. At t equal to 3, it is minus?
1 by
2. 1 by 2. It keeps repeating, right? So, write the x-axis as t equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, right? And you know y-axis, how to mark it. Put dots and join those dots.
So, when they overlap, don't they cancel out each other? That one.
No, we'll discuss that. Yeah, yeah, that overlap will happen. Because it is going negative, no? Right, when k is 3 by 2, that is what I have taken that value as 3 by 2. What happens if I take higher value? What is the problem to discuss? In the previous case, it was not crossing that zero line, right? It was within that zero line. But now it is crossing zero line and it is becoming negative. Yes or no? That 1 plus k m of t value, it is crossing zero and becoming negative, right? Yes, who has it drawn? Anyone can show, you can present, no? With your camera, you can show it. Yes, Srujan, I have drawn, man. B.S. Srujan.
Sir, doing.
Doing. Gautam, where are
you? Doing, sir.
What about Girish?
Doing, sir.
ನೀ ಎಷ್ಟೊತ್ತು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀಯ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲ
ಸರ್ ಶುಡ್ ವಿ ಡ್ರಾ ಬೋತ್ ದ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್
ಯಾ ಯಾ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಬೋತ್
ದೇಲ್ ಓವರ್ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ ನೋ ಸರ್
ಯಾ ಓವರ್ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಸೀ ಪ್ರಿವಿಯಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಓವರ್ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ ರೈಟ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಕೆ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಓವರ್ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ Just to try to understand what is the difficulty if it is overlapping.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Tipana.
Doing, sir, doing.
ಮಾಡಿ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕು ನೋಡಿ ಬೇರೆಯವ್ರೆಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದಾರಲ್ಲ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ನೋ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಪಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಡನ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಸೌವಿಕ್ ರಾಯ್
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್
ಡನ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್
ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್
Yes, Mohammed Anas. Mohammed Anas. Mm-hmm. See, if you are not responding means you are not there in the class. Just you have logged in, somewhere else is there. Mohammed, I will make absent. When I call your name, you should...
No, sir. I'm doing, sir.
Doing. Then you should say, no, see how others are responding, right? Otherwise, what I will learn?
Yes, sir. I was busy doing it, sir.
Oh, okay, okay. Busy in doing. Girish?
Sir.
Then Martadi, huh?
Yes, sir.
Are you doing it, man?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Still, how long you take time to do that? How many of you have completed? Anyone can share and show. I would like to see. You can share. You know how to present, right? Will you do that? Okay, let me share my slide, okay? Show from my slide. Okay, able to see now? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Please, so otherwise, see, sometimes if network goes now, you will not be able to know. Even the recording will go. So when I ask some questions, so if you are responding, then I will assume that the network is there and we are in touch. It is going on. Okay. So don't hesitate to say yes or no. Okay. Okay. Can you... this quality you are aware, right? How to calculate its maximum minimum value, which right? I hope this everybody has done. Yeah, so this is what I have shown the in step-by-step calculation of those values, right? At t equal to 0 is what, then at t equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on, right? And I'm saying it is the value of
so
yeah,
so how will you draw the carrier wave for this one, because it's overlapping, right?
I will tell. So my this slide is visible now for you people, right?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, I will go to this one. So this is what I expected you all to write. Done like this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I need not show this much detail, right? I hope you have written this line, x-axis, y-axis, you marked 1, 2, 3, right? And even this value, you see, that is from maximum is 5/2, right? And minimum is -1/2. I have marked like this, right? Then what is next point is at t equal to 0, you get 5/2. You're putting one dot here, right? Then at t equal to 1, what you're getting? -1/2 you're getting, right? Yes, sir, you're putting one dot here. Then again at t equal to 2, you're getting 5/2. So on top of this, at this point, you're putting one dot. Then at t equal to 3, you're getting -1/2. So at this point, you're putting one dot. So you're going to join those, right? So I have joined this one. Okay, is it clear? Joining of this one, only for positive. Similarly, the mirror image of this I have done. Okay, that is from, it is varies from what? -5/2 to 1/2. I think it is shown with different color, right? So -5/2 to 1/2 drawn. Similarly, t equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on drawn. So with respect to that, we have written here this graph, right? I hope it is clear. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
See, this is done, and similar to that, the mirror image of this is also done. So looking at this, what we are finding is there is a what? Means, see, looking at this one, what I can say, this is the zero reference line, right? So this what is this one? This one is my 1 plus k m of t, right? This graph, what I have drawn. So it is crossing. It is reaching zero value and going negative. Isn't it? It is going negative. And similarly for other one also, right? So there will be a overlap of these two envelopes at this point, okay? At some point of time, those two envelopes are getting overlapped. Okay, so with that, what I have written is here the carrier, right? To show that, and even the phase of the carrier is also going to change. There will be a phase reversal. Even with respect to the envelope also, we can say, right, there is a phase reversal. When you draw both, we say there is a phase reversal, right, at this point. Yes or no? I hope you understand, no? Phase reversal means, right? So there is a phase reversal. So with respect to that, I am writing here carrier signal also with a phase reversal starting from this point. Means if it is ending with this point, then you have to change the phase. Okay. Phase reversal, you understand, no? One it starts with 0 degree, another one will be opposite to that. That is 180 degree. Okay. Or,
sir, yeah. Won't this overlapping cause any distortion or anything?
Yeah, yeah, that is what. This overlapping of this leads to distortion. I will come to that. First, I would like to clarify how to draw this. And then I will go to the next.
Yeah,
okay. Okay, this is done. This waveform is done, na?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, done.
Shall I go to the next slide?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. See, I have made a slide step by step to explain. Okay. So what I wrote in the previous slide, I've written the diagram. Then now I'm saying at this point, right? At this point, what I've written is 1 plus k m of t. After substituting the value of k as 3/2 and m of t as what? Cosine of pi t. That is reaching 0. At this point, it is reaching 0. This is I've written which is equal to 0. It is all clear, na? Then it is going negative. So that step I have written in the next slide. See here, some more points are added. Right? One point is with this, 0 what I said. Then I am saying this 1 plus k m of t is going negative. Okay, 1 plus k m of t starts becoming negative. Right, this portion. Okay, this portion is negative, right? Then what I have written here, see phase reversal in the modulating signal because of this envelope, right? This is a modulating signal, right? So I'm saying there is a phase reversal at this point and similarly at this point also, okay? So that phase reversal in the next, this one I have written, right? So with respect to this phase reversal, what happens, there will be a phase reversal of the carrier also and phase reversal of the message signal also. That we call as envelope distortion. Okay, so it has to go like this, right? But there is an overlap here, no? That overlap of this and phase reversal of the carrier, we call it as a envelope distortion. So let me just say how we can avoid and what is the impact of this envelope distortion also. Okay, fine. Nobody
yes,
responded.
Sir.
Why others cannot speak? Only yes. Prajwal and some people are interacting. Kuber, right? Prajwal, Sagar, and all. What about see 50 plus is strength? Only when I call their name, they say yes or no. I don't understand why. What is the difficulty in saying yes, no, and interacting, asking doubts? See, if you ask doubts, then only I understand, no, whether you are with me or not. Right? Definitely there will be a lot of doubts. Okay, I made my best effort to convey in a very simple and understandable manner. I don't think I have conveyed like this in the previous years, what I feel. Okay, is it clear at this point of time for this waveform? Can I go to the next slide?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so some more points added here. Okay, you forget about this, all this data, what I've written here. So this thing is discussed, right? And this is also, I think this slide is repeated, same thing. Okay, I will go to the next one. Yeah, so what is added in this slide is, the upper part is same, okay? What I saying is, see the envelope, right? That is 1 plus Ka m of t will be going, it has to go like this, right? And it will be going like this, right? But that is a true envelope, what I have seen with that diagram. This is a true envelope, right? But what happens when it is tracking, okay? Means at the receiver side, right? It will track in a other way. Means it will come to this point, till 0 point, then it will go back like this. So that tracking is written here, okay? Tracking of this envelope. Okay, at the receiver side, to get back the information, it will be tracking the envelope of the modulated signal. With respect to that, I am saying, okay, this is my true envelope, right? But what happens after reaching 0 point, it will go back like this. Means it will be taking this point, right? So I said that leads to the envelope distortion, right? How do I overcome this envelope distortion? So I need to come to a conclusion that I need to decide about the value of 1 plus Ka m of t, right? Whether it should be greater than 1 or less than 1. And so on. And to say that it should be greater than 1 or less than 1, I need to choose the value of Ka appropriately. Yes or no? Yeah, that explanation is written here. Okay, to avoid envelope distortion, right, we need to choose the value of Ka appropriately, as I said. Right. So the value of that 1 plus Ka m of t has to be greater than or equal to 0, isn't it? Then only I can say there is no distortion. Yes or no? People are not saying yes, sir. Yeah, see, I will go back to this previous slide. We have seen when 1 plus Km of t is greater than 1, right? Greater than 0, right? Means, yes. If this is positive, no? Then there was no overlap, right? Then we say there is no distortion. But in this case, we are getting distorted one, right? Right, when K is 1 by 2, there was no distortion. That is what I wanted to show that. Okay, we come to this. Yeah. Yeah, so this is the condition, okay? To say no distortion, I need to have the value of this one, 1 plus K m of t has to be greater than or equal to 0. Even if it is 0, fine. It is exact matching. It is 100% what we can say. Okay, it should be actually greater than 0. Greater than or equal to 0. Right? What I mean to say is, this value, that is Ka, and the minimum value of the message signal. Okay, that is why I have written minimum m of t. Minimum value of m of t should be what? Less than or equal to 1. Are you catching this point? First thing I said, to avoid envelope distortion, right? I need to choose a proper value of k, right? When I choose the value of k as 1/2, I was not finding any envelope distortion problem, right? When I have chosen the value of k as 3/2, I could understand that, yes, there is a envelope distortion. There is a distortion in the modulated signal. That leads to what? Error, isn't it? So how do I overcome that? So for that, this is the condition. What is that condition? I need to have this 1 plus k m of t should be greater than or equal to 0. Then I can say there is no distortion. So for that, what is this one? I said k a and the minimum value of the message signal. I can say even the magnitude also, both, right, should be less than or equal to 1. Right? So please note down this point. So this is the condition to say without distortion or to avoid envelope distortion, what the value of k should be and how it can avoid that. Okay? It has to satisfy this condition. The value of 1 plus k m of t should be greater than or equal to 0. Okay? And what I said, k a, the magnitude of minimum value of m of t should be less than or equal to 1. Then I say there will be no envelope distortion. And this entire thing, k a into this magnitude of minimum value of m of t is denoted by mu. Okay? That mu is known as the modulation index. We call that as a modulation index. So I am using a new word, right? That is a modulation index, which is represented by the symbol mu. What is that mu? I can say, so mu is equal to Ka, right? So the magnitude of minimum value of m of t.
So over here, the minimum value of m of t is referred to the minimum amplitude of m of t.
Yeah, minimum amplitude of the m of t. Yes, exactly. Amplitude only. Yes, any doubts in this slide? You could understand, no? What is the criteria, okay, to avoid envelope distortion? What we need to say, that depends on the appropriate value of Ka, right? That is 1 plus Ka m of t has to be greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so I denoted this Ka, then the magnitude of the minimum value of m of t should be less than or equal to 1. I denoted this by a letter called mu, that I call it as a modulation index. We call this as a modulation index. So modulation index is equal to what? Ka into the magnitude of minimum amplitude of the message signal. Okay, that is known as, means it is a multiplication of the sensitivity factor and the minimum magnitude of the message signal.
Sir,
yeah, tell me.
Sir, that modulation index, can you show that in the first graph that you did, like how I'm not getting?
I will show that. I will come to that. Okay, first let me complete this. I will come to that also. Yeah. So you will be able to define, no, what is modulation index with respect to that, right? Mu is equal to, I said, Ka into the magnitude of what? Minimum magnitude of the message signal, right? So for no distortion, I said the value of this as mu, right, it should be less than or equal to 1. Means the value of mu, or the modulation index, should be less than or equal to 1. Then we say there will be no distortion. Okay. If the value of this modulation index is greater than 1, when it will be greater than 1 and when it will be less than 1, both the cases I have taken. Okay, I will come to that. I think from your side also you will be able to say now. Is it possible to say from your side with respect to all this? Okay, anyhow, Prajwala has asked that question. I will go back to that and say, but with your understanding, see now what I said, what is the value of mu? Mu should be less than or equal to 1, na, to say there is no distortion. And if mu is greater than 1, then we say the carrier is over modulated. Okay, the carrier is said to be overmodulated. That leads to envelope distortion. Okay. Yes, so with the value of Ka, what I have taken, 1 by 2 and 3 by 2, right? K, that is 1 by 2 comes under what? And 3 by 2 comes under what category? So should you already know what is the minimum value of that, right? And you can say what is the value of mu. Here only write mu is equal to K is what? 1 by 2, right? What is the minimum magnitude of the message signal for the first case when K is equal to 1 by 2 is taken? It is 1 by 2, no?
1 by 2 only, sir. Mm-hmm.
So it's 1 by 4.
It is 1 by 4 you are saying. I will come to that. Okay, before saying for sinusoidal signal, I will show with respect to that. Okay, I will show with respect to that. See here, this is what the diagram, no? What I have drawn when K is 1 by 2. Okay, I hope you will be able to recall this diagram. This is the waveform what we have drawn for K is equal to 1 by 2, right? So here what is that m of t is cosine of pi t, right? The minimum magnitude of this is what? Cos pi t, that is minus 1, right? So since it's a magnitude, it will be 1. So mu is equal to K into minimum magnitude of the message signal, right? So it is 1, right? So K value is what? 1 by 2. Yes or no? Sir,
yes,
for mu has to be less than 1, right? This 1 by 2 is less than 1 or not?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sir. Yeah. Yes, ma'am. See, here I have taken minimum, the magnitude of minimum, the value of m of t. What is my m of t? M of t is this, right? Cosine of pi t. Whatever the example I have taken, right? I wrote m of t is equal to cosine of 2 pi fm t. I have taken the value of fm as 1 by 2. Right, the 2 get cancelled, then I got m of t is equal to cosine of pi t, right? So the minimum value of this is what, minus 1, since I'm taking magnitude of that, so you know it is 1 only, right? Just I'm substituting the value of that and the value of Ka. So Ka is 1 by 2, right? So 1 by 2 into 1 is 1 by 2 only. So now the value of mu, that is the modulation index, is less than 1, right? And we say there is no envelope distortion. And another case, that is when K is 3 by 2, right? So that is the case I have written here. When K is 3 by 2, right? Even for that case also, the M of T is same thing, right? That is the cosine of pi T. Its minimum magnitude is 1 by 1 only, right? So K is 3 by 2, right? So mu is equal to what? 3 by 2 into 1, right? So now the value of mu, the modulation index will be 3 by 2, which is greater than 1. 3 by 2 is nothing but what? 1.5, no? Is it 1.5?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah. So now the value of mu is 1.5, which is 3 by 2. So which is greater than 1, then we say it is overmodulated. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So that is why we say to avoid envelope distortion, we need to choose the proper value of K. Okay, so now let me say the same thing with respect to the sinusoidal signal. We are taking m of t, okay, for a sinusoidal message signal. I say m of t is equal to am cosine of 2 by fm t, right? Here am is the what? Amplitude of the message signal, and fm is the frequency of the message signal, right? So here I have specified the value of amplitude of the message signal. I am writing it as am, right? So the minimum value of this is what? Minus AM, right? Yes or no? The minimum value.
Yes,
so,
sir.
So written in magnitude form, minus AM. So it becomes AM only, right? So I can express the modulation index as what? Mu is equal to KA into AM. KA into AM.
Sir, so it's time up, sir.
No. Mine is continuous. Mine only class, no? Fourth hour.
Oh, you are only taking, sir. Okay, fine.
Okay, so the modulation index is equal to what we can say? The sensitivity, right, into the amplitude of the message signal, right? So mu is equal to k into am. Is it clear? So this is for the sinusoidal message signal. Okay. Yes, if you have any doubts, you can ask about these things. Understanding and saying about the choosing the value of k or even
in the previous derivations and all, we have, I mean, the formulas, we have taken message signal as just cos pi t, you know, sir?
Yeah.
Sir, how we like it became cos pi t because we substituted 1/2 in place of the message frequency.
Oh, that is frequency, yeah.
Okay. That's it, sir. That's it. I just had that tiny doubt.
Fine. Yeah, no issues. Because first time you're hearing, first time listening, right? No issues. You can ask any number of doubts. Not an issue. So ultimately, this formula should be there in your mind. How do we express the AM wave fundamentally? What is that? S of t into 1 plus k m of t into carrier. What is that carrier? AC into cos 2 pi of ct. I have rewritten here as AC of 1 plus k m of t into cosine of 2 pi of ct. So this we call as a standard amplitude modulation.
Sir?
Yeah.
Why did we assume message frequency as 1/2, sir, in this case?
Oh, just it is an example. It is an example. You can take another value, you can draw, so you'll get different waveform.
Sir, but practically the FM can't be so low, right?
Which one?
The frequency that you told.
Yeah, just I'm taking an example to make you understand what is choosing the value of k with these things.
Fine.
You can take another value and you can draw it.
Sir, the minimum value of m of t is like always one only, you know, sir.
Yeah, always one only. For this student, this one, man. So, no, here, see, m of t is equal to, here, what I have written, cos, cosine of 2 by fmt, right? Here, what is its magnitude? It is one only. But in the other case, at the end, I have written generalized formula, that is am cosine of 2 by fmt, right? The value of am can vary now. For this example, I have taken the magnitude of the message signal as 1.
Okay, sir.
I hope you understood this, sir. Right, at the end, I have written for a sinusoidal message signal, I can express m of t, which is equal to am cosine of 2 by fmt. Right, that value of am can be varied. And even here, I have taken the amplitude of the carrier is also 1. Even the value of this can also be varied. It can be 2 also, 3 also, right?
Sir, can you go to the generalized form, sir, that A minus AM mod?
What one? Modulation index, huh?
Yeah. No, general form of this. That's what you were telling, no, sir, that minimum value of a message signal.
I will come to that. Yeah. This point you're asking, man.
Next slide, sir. Next.
Yeah, in this only I have written, see, 1 plus k a m of t, right? This has to be greater than or equal to 0, right? For no distortion, because we could understand when this 1 plus k a m of t crosses 0 line and goes negative, that leads to distortion, right? That is why I said complete this factor has to be greater than or equal to 0. With this, I am taking this Ka, right? The magnitude of the minimum value of this message signal has to be less than or equal to 1. Yeah, what is that doubt you have here? and I'm calling this Ka the magnitude of what? The minimum, right? Value of the message signal, right? As modulation index. I have written Ka, this one as mu, which is equal to modulation index, that has to be less than or equal to 1. So which is multiplied, no? Ka into minimum value of that. So Ka, choosing the value of Ka is also plays an important role here, right? Though the minimum value of M of T is 1 in the considered example, right? So when the value of Ka is 1 by 2, what happens? When the value of Ka is 3 by 2, what happens? You understood. When the value of Ka is 1 by 2, the value of modulation index was less than 1, right? It was half. But when the value of Ka was 3 by 2, I got the modulation index as how much? How much I got? When the
1 by 2,
yeah, 3 by 2, I got the modulation index as 3 by 2, means 1.5, so which is greater than 1. So that has led to the error of distortion. We say it is, that means the carrier is overmodulated. Is it clear or not that point? Less than 1, greater than 1, substituting the value of Ka into the minimum value of that. Yes, so this point was 1 only, right? But the value of K is varied in that example. Okay, I have shown for both. Okay, shall I go to the next topic? Or do you have any doubts? If you have any doubts, you can ask me. I hope you all have noted all these equations. This is for sinusoidal message signal, I said. Right? Mu is equal to Ka into AM. So that is modulation index is equal to sensitivity times the amplitude of the message signal. Yes, if it is done with this, shall I go to the next topic?
We'll read, sir, we're copying.
Copy. Yes, is it done?
Can you go back to the slide?
Slide. Yeah, is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Sir, it will be good if you can share the PPT, sir, for our reference.
Yeah, I will share. Other people also have asked. I will share.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Sir.
If it is done, shall I go to the next slide? You have noted. Not saying anything. Whether I should go or you have still any doubts to ask, you can ask. No worry. Or shall I ask some questions from my side to you all? I think I should do that rather than going to the next slide. Isn't it? I don't think you are taking so much of time to write this much. Don't kill my time like this. If you have not written, is okay. If you have written, please say it is done. You all wanted a break or what? Yes. Yes, you are all taking break or what? Who is responding?
Done, sir.
Done. Shall I go to the next one then?
Yes,
sir. Yeah, this already I have shown. This is a waveform which we have said that when the modulation index is less than 1, right? And this is a case whereas we are saying that the modulation index is greater than 1, right? Okay. So this is another waveform, okay, which you can note down for this amplitude modulated signal. Okay, this is my M of T taken. And here, see, this is without distortion. And another one waveform is there, this is with distortion. Two cases. In this case, that the magnitude of Km of t is less than 1, right, for all t. and for this case, right, the k and m of t, it is greater than 1 for some of the values of t. That is why there is a phase reversal, okay, at this point. So that phase reversal we say as the angle of distortion.
Sir, can you go to the previous slide just for a second, sir?
Previous slide, now, okay. This one, huh?
This one? This one only, sir. Okay, sir, that's it.
Yeah, already this slide has been shown. Just showing here, when case, this is for the case of when case 3 by 2. What is the value of modulation index?
Got it.
Okay. So all this explanation I have done. Okay. I don't want to again repeat the same thing. I will share the PPTs now. You can read that. Fine. Yeah. Maybe I have taken here the frequency of the message signal as a W. Okay. In the previous example, there I have written the frequency of the message signal as FM will be consistent with this notation. Okay. All of a sudden, you don't. Think that over where here W there FM. Okay, so frequency of the message signal is W or FM. And this condition I said, no, frequency of the carrier will be much greater than the frequency of the message signal with respect to that. Yeah, so now let me say how do we represent in frequency domain. Okay, so far what the waveform and the discussions is done with respect to time domain. Okay, so to discuss with respect to frequency domain, you all know what we need to do. We need to take the Fourier transform of the signal, right? So here my signal is what? The amplitude modulated signal, which what I have written, it is S of t is equal to Kc of 1 plus Km of t cos 2 pi fct, right? So this I'm just expanding by multiplying AC cos 2 by FCT with respect to this bracket, right? So what I get, I can have AC cosine of 2 by FCT, right? Plus AC into KA into M of T into cos 2 by FCT. So these are the two terms I get, right? So now I need to take the Fourier transform of this equation. Okay. So what I will be able to write? In the frequency domain, S of F, right, which is equal to, right? So we know the Fourier transform of cosine of 2 by FCT will be equal to what? Del of F minus FC plus del of F plus FC by 2, right? And here, since the amplitude of the carrier is AC, so that is why I have written here AC by 2 del of F minus FC plus del of F plus FC. Is it clear with respect to the first term? That is why I asked you at the beginning only to find out what is the Fourier transform of cosine of 2 pi FCT. If you have done that, then you will be able to understand this term. Means by substituting in the formula, right? See, the Fourier transform of x of t is what x of f, right? How do we define that? X of f is equal to? Yes, anyone can tell the formula. If the signal in time domain is x of t, right? And its Fourier transform we represent as what? Capital X of f. So which is equal to what? That's what we get. What is the formula? At least anyone can say the formula, no? General formula. Yes, Girish, can you tell man? The Fourier transform, the definition, how do we define the Fourier transform when a signal? X of f is equal to what? Yes, quickly. Yes, no answer. Girish.
Sir.
Yeah, no definition, you know, x of f is equal to what we can write, man. Integral. Not remembered. Integral from minus infinity to infinity x of t into e power minus j 2 pi f t into dt. Yes, sir, no?
Yes, sir.
Here, what is x of t? The entire thing. So I am applying part by part, right? First, if I take only this much AC cosine of 2 pi FCT, so we will be expressing this cosine of 2 pi FCT in terms of exponential function. So you know cos theta will be written as what? In terms of exponential form, what we can write, man? Cos theta is equal to. How do we express cos theta is equal to e power j theta plus e power minus j theta by 2? Have you remembered this formula? Cos theta can be written as e power j theta plus e power minus j theta by 2. Here theta is what? The 2 pi fct. Replace theta by 2 pi fct. Okay, substitute that value in that equation. Multiply with e power minus j 2 pi ft, take the commonality, then you will be getting something in terms of integral from minus infinity e power of something, right, into dt plus another term e power of minus of something into dt. So for that integral from minus infinity e power x into dx, right, for that it will be what? Impulse function. So that is why I am replacing that by this one, del of f minus fc plus del of f plus fc. That is what the first part is. Okay, for the second part is what it is, ac ka m of t into cosine of 2 pi fct is there. So m of t is one signal, and this one cosine of 2 pi fct is another signal, right? So two signals are here multiplied, right, in time domain. So you know what is the modulation formula, right? Or multiplication of two signals in time domain, what will be its equivalent in frequency domain? So with respect to that, if you apply that, what I can write is AC into KA by 2, right? M of, instead of delta, we are writing here M, because this is M of T is there, right? So M of F minus FC plus M of F plus FC. So this is how we write the Fourier transform of this equation. Yes, how many of you could, I think in between steps are there. I have not shown the steps. If you want, I will show. Okay, that is also there, but I expect you to do this in between steps. We have already known things, these things, right? So take time and can you do it and say whether you are getting this or not by tomorrow, I mean in the next class. Okay, as of now, just I'm saying what is the Fourier transform of this, fine. So how do I represent this graphically? Similar to the waveform which we have written in time domain, no? That is amplitude versus time. Similar to that, how do we draw this in frequency domain? Can you draw that? Okay, so here is the spectrum of that signal. So I am assuming this is the spectrum of the message signal. Okay, it looks like a triangle, right? So this is my spectrum of the message signal. So all in the frequency domain only, right? So magnitude versus frequency I have drawn. I am assuming that the message signal lies in the range of what? Minus W to plus W hertz. Okay. Since it is frequency, we say it is hertz, right? And at f equal to zero, it has a magnitude amplitude, right? So this is my the spectrum of the message signal. Okay. So with respect to the previous equation, what I have? I have delta function, right? One is at plus fc, another one is at minus fc with a magnitude of how much? Ac by 2. Right? So first I need to represent those two impulse functions, right, on the frequency axis with a magnitude of ac by 2. The next one is what? See, m of f I know. That here I have the expression that is shifted by plus or minus fc. Right? M of f minus fc, then plus m of f plus fc with what magnitude? K into ac by 2. So that is what that one only shown here. Okay, first you need to write the impulse function at one is at plus fc, right? Another one is at minus fc. Then you have to write this, the shifted version of m of f at what value? At plus or minus fc. So with that, I'm getting this diagram. Okay, as you said, negative side. And with what magnitude? This is the magnitude 1 by 2 k ac. And any of this maximum value is m of 0 is written, right? That one. So note of this spectrum. So this is what we say, the spectrum of the message signal or baseband signal. And this one is the spectrum of the AM wave. So here the highest frequency of the message signal is what? W, right? So while drawing the spectrum of the AM signal, so what will be the highest frequency? It will be FC plus W. Okay. The lowest frequency will be FC minus W or positive side. Similarly here, it is minus FC minus W and then minus FC plus W it will be. So the frequencies above the carrier frequency in the this one, we call it as a upper sideband. Okay. And below FC are known as the lower sideband, we say. Similarly for the negative frequencies also. Upper sideband and the lower sideband. Is it written this waveform? Yes, sir. Is it over? Drawing of this waveform. I have noted this equation, previous equation. This is in frequency domain. So from this waveform, you will be able to say, okay, what is the bandwidth required for transmitting the amplitude modulated signal? So what is bandwidth? How do you define the bandwidth? It is the difference of highest frequency of the signal to the lowest frequency of the signal, right? So from the spectrum, you will be able to say the highest frequency of this AM wave is what? FC plus W. and the lowest frequency is what? Fc minus W, right? So the difference of these two will give you the expression for bandwidth of the amplitude modulated signal. Okay, that is Fc plus W minus of Fc minus W, right? So Fc will get cancelled, minus Fc plus Fc. So it will be what? We say it is 2W. Okay, this is the transmission bandwidth which we denote as a BT or AM wave. So we can say it is the difference of what, maximum frequency minus minimum frequency. I said the maximum frequency is Fc plus W and the minimum frequency is what? Fc minus W. So we get the transmission bandwidth as 2W. Means what? W is the what? Highest frequency of the message signal, right? So the transmission bandwidth required for transmitting the amplitude modulated signal will be twice the highest frequency of the message signal. That's what we say. Okay, means if I have the highest frequency of the message signal as 5 kilohertz, then I will be able to say what is the bandwidth required for transmitting the amplitude modulated wave. So is it possible to say anyone how much it will be? If the value of W is 5 kilohertz, what is the transmission bandwidth required for transmitting AM wave?
10 kilohertz.
10 kilohertz, right? So twice the highest frequency of the message signal.
Sir, minimum frequency was minus Fc minus W, no, sir?
I will show you. No, here it is just mirror image of this one, man. We can have positive frequency, no, right? It is just mirror image of this. Okay.
Oh, okay.
With respect to this, we are saying what is the highest frequency? It is Fc plus W. And minimum frequency is what? Fc minus W. So this is a complete AM signal. So amplitude modulated signal will have three components. Okay, what are those three components? One is the carrier, isn't it? That is why we represent with this impulse function. I will go back to this equation only. Yeah, here with respect to this, see, this is what the first term is, what, man? Carrier, no? Yes, sir. AC cosine of 2 by FC is a carrier.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah, plus, I have two terms here. One is M of T, another one is again carrier. Those two are multiplied, right? If I take here in this example, I have taken M of T, means the spectrum of the message signal as that shape. That is just for understanding only, purpose of illustration, what I have shown here, the shape of the message signal, okay? If I consider M of T is like AM cosine of 2 by FMT, then accordingly you will get a different this one here, right? If I take M of T is equal to AM cosine of 2 by FMT, then what you will get? That is AC, AM, right? AA, then cosine of 2 by FCT into cosine of 2 by FMT. Then we need to apply here cos A cos B formula. You have to expand that. Right? Cosine of A plus B is what? That is cosine of A, that is cos A into cos B. Cos A cos B is what? Which is equal to cos of A plus B, right? Plus cos of A minus B by 2, right?
Yes, sir.
After expanding that, we need to write the, we need to take the Fourier transform and we'll be able to say that. I will come to that by taking sinusoidal signal as M of T. Okay. So here just I have shown with respect to the message spectrum taking this shape of triangular and which exists over the interval minus W to W. Okay. Isn't it? So I say three components. One is this one, unmodulated carrier, which exists at FC. Then I have upper side band. I call this an upper side band, I said, no? This one, along with lower side band. So the amplitude modulated signal have three components. Unmodulated carrier, upper side band, and the lower side band. So this picture will be clear when I take M of T as a sinusoidal signal and after multiplication, taking Fourier transform, illustrating with the impulse functions, then the picture will be clear. Okay. So now I have drawn with respect to this shape of the message signal. Maybe you are finding it, how does it shifting, right? Just see what we say, modulation is nothing but what shifting of the frequency of the message signal to that of the carrier, right? So here m of t in this range, it has been shifted to this frequency range from fc to fc plus w and fc to fc minus w, right? This is the highest frequency and this is the lowest frequency. In that way, you can think right now. Yeah, here is the diagram where I have taken m of t as my cosine signal. Means both I have shown here, time domain and as well as frequency domain waveforms. Okay, so this is in time domain, right? Cosine wave it is. And this is my unmodulated carrier, right? And this one is what? Amplitude modulated signal. So this is in time domain what you have drawn. And if you take the Fourier transform this cosine, I will be getting what? Two impulse functions, right? So if I write m of t is equal to am cosine of 2 by fmt, I will be getting the impulse functions, one at plus fm, another one is at minus fm. So that is what is shown here as a spectrum of the message signal. Similarly for carrier, I get the impulse functions, right? One at plus fc, another one is at minus fc. Then the am signal, right? That will be what? This is fc, right? One at fc, that is impulse function. And this one is what? Fc plus fm point. And this one is fc minus fm point. So if you take fc plus fm minus of fc minus fm, you'll get bandwidth as 2fm. That is what is shown here. So this is by taking m of t as cosine wave. And even carrier is also cosine. And this is a modulated signal. So I will show you the mathematical analysis of these waveforms. Okay, step by step, how I have shown for other things, maybe in the next class. In the meantime, you also, all of you, I think all of you should do this by yourself first. Okay, if any difficulty while solving this, I can help you. Take m of t as cosine of, that is am, cosine of 2 by fmt. Similarly, C of t as AC cosine of 2 by FCT, right? With respect to that, you write the expression for S of t in time domain, right? And similarly, in frequency domain by taking Fourier transform. You do that, the mathematical works, okay? Is it okay? Will you do this by Monday? And I should be able to see that in the Google Classroom, all of you post that mathematical analysis of these things. Okay. Yes. Now let us have a discussion about questions and answers. So now let me ask questions from my side. Okay. So far we have discussed many things, right? Vishal?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you define in general what is modulation, man?
So modulation is nothing but imposing message signal on a carrier signal.
Okay. What is it? Imposing?
So varying one or more properties of the carrier signal with message signal.
Okay. Okay. No, you are imposing or superimposing?
Superimposing.
Superimposing. As you are using word imposing, that is why I ask it twice.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Fine. Yes. Aditi, yes. Aditi. Aditi, yes. So no response means no attendance. Yes, Ananta Padmanabha. Ananta Padmanabha.
Sir.
Can you define amplitude modulation, man? You unmute your mic now. Ananta. Yes, Ananta Kattani.
Sir.
What is AMN?
Amplitude modulation.
Define. See, your friend Vishal said in general. I have asked him to say the general definition of modulation. Now I am very specific about AM.
Sir, by varying amplitude, the modulation is done, sir.
That is fine, man. You tell me what is amplitude modulation. Be very specific.
Sir,
in amplitude modulation, can I vary frequency also?
No, sir. By mixing it with a carrier wave, radio carrier wave.
Fine, man. To say it is an amplitude modulation, I am varying the amplitude of the carrier, or can I vary both amplitude and frequency also?
Sir, only amplitude.
Amplitude modulation.
Sir, only amplitude, sir.
Only amplitude, right? So only if I vary the amplitude of the carrier signal in accordance with the message signal, then I say it is a amplitude modulation. So other characteristics, I'm keeping it constant, right? Frequency.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, Ashwini.
Sir?
Yeah, can you define what is modulation index? Modulation index. Yes, how much time?
Sir, it is the ratio of fundamental components of the amplitude.
I think you are putting in Google and you are saying. I never said that definition. No, it is a ratio of something. Have I said? Any other people can say? I didn't talk about any ratio of fundamental something. Yes? Modulation index. Represented by what letter? Yes, what about Karunya? Karunya.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I asked you the question, what is modulation index?
Sir, it shows how much the wave is modulated.
How much?
Like how much we varied the carrier signal.
So modulation index will say how much a carrier is varied, Then you have not understood what it is.
Sir, it's a product of sensitivity
and
amplitude.
It is a product of what?
It is product of sensitivity and amplitude.
amplitude of what? Is it amplitude of carrier?
Message, sir.
Wait, let us tell Ashwini.
It's an amplitude of wave.
Amplitude of what wave? Huh? So many waves will be there, no? In that, which wave amplitude? You have to be very clear.
Message.
Message. Abhishek Reddy. Abhishek Reddy.
Sir.
Yeah, can you define modulation, man?
Sir, modulation, sir. Sir, superimposing message signal into the carrier signal.
Superimposing of the message signal into the carrier signal, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, ma'am. Fine. Okay. Hegde? Yes, Hegde.
Yes, sir.
Can you define what is amplitude of modulation, man? Amplitude modulation.
It transmitting the messages with the radio carrier.
No. What is amplitude modulation? You define it. Yes, quickly. Amplitude modulation. What, you are not listening? Already some of your friends have said, no, what is amplitude modulation? What about Rakshita? Rakshita K. Munro.
Yeah.
Yeah, can you define what is amplitude modulation?
It is defined as a process in which the amplitude of the carrier wave is varied about a mean value linearly with band, phase band.
Just reading from my slide, I think. You should tell your understanding. No, what I said, the amplitude of the carrier is varied in accordance with the message signal. Okay, that is the amplitude modulation. Yes, Souvik Roy. Souvik Roy?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you tell the expression for AM wave in time domain? How do we express the amplitude modulated signal in time domain or as a function of time? Amplitude modulated wave, man. Expression, mathematical expression. You can't tell. What about Sanket Sina? Sanket Sina.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you tell me the expression of AM wave in time domain?
No, sir.
No, you can't. Why? So many times it is repeated, no? What about Shreyas? Shreyas.
Yes, sir.
Unmute madakke ishtadadre henge? I am asking you to tell the expression of AM wave in as a function of time. What is that, man? It is written S of t is equal to what? 1 plus Ka m of t times the carrier. Right? So 1 plus Ka m of t times the carrier means what? How do we represent carrier? Ac cosine of 2 pi fct. That is what is the expression of Am wave as a function of time. Is it clear? S of t is equal to 1 plus Ka m of t times, right, the carrier, that is AC cosine of 2 pi FCT. Yes, Dipana.
Yes, sir.
Can you define modulation index, man?
Modulation index, sir.
Yeah. Yes, silent means what? No answer, huh? What about Vishal?
Sir?
Yeah, can you define modulation index?
Sir, is a product of sensitivity and amplitude of the message signal.
Yeah, right? It is a product of sensitivity and the amplitude of the message signal. What's the point? Then what is the takeaway for today's class, sir? When you don't say, then zero. Isn't it? Yes, Siddharth. Siddharth. Siddharth.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you tell the condition, okay, for the AM wave with no distortion? What is the condition to be satisfied to say there will be no envelope distortion?
So the value of mu should be greater than 1.
It should be greater than 1, means the modulation index is greater than 1, then we say there is no distortion.
Less than 1.
Less than 1. So yes, when, sir, the value of mu is less than 1, we say there is no distortion. When the value of, yes, mu is greater than 1, we say there will be a distortion. So that distortion is known as what? What happens when the value of mu is greater than 1? We say the carrier is overmodulated. Right?
Yes. Yes.
Carrier signal is overmodulated. We say that is known as the overmodulation. That is, that leads to envelope distortion. Right?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, Girish. Girish.
Sure, sir.
Yeah, can you tell the criteria to say that there is no overlap or there is no distortion in the amplitude modulated signal? What is the criteria to say that there is no distortion? Girish, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, I hope everybody has written your USN in the chat box. Yeah, no answer, no, Girish. You should say you know or you don't know. Yes, what about Anand?
Sir, mu should be greater than 1.
Oh, mu should be greater than 1 to say there is no distortion.
The expression is better, sir.
Hello, expression is better with respect to mu. Yellow modulation index will be yellow.
Adalo, sir, it should be greater.
If the value of modulation index is greater than 1, then we say there is no distortion.
Yes, sir. 100%
then there will be no distortion.
Oh, sir.
No, no. You have misunderstood. You have misunderstood the concept. You just check the graph of when mu less than 1. How does it looks? When mu greater than 1, how does it looks?
Sorry, sir.
No, need to come. Yes, what about Namita?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you say when the value of mu is greater than 1, what happens?
So, the condition for no distortion is mu value should be less than or equal to 1. So, if it is greater than 1, there will be the distortion.
Yeah, very good. Okay, when the value of mu is should be less than 1 for no distortion. And when the value of mu is greater than 1, we say there will be a distortion in the modulated signal. Fine. Yes, what about Rohit Joshi? Rohit Joshi. Yes, Danish. Danish. Hello, Danish.
Yes, sir.
Can you say what is modulation man? Danish Kumar. Can you define what is modulation?
Sir, others can leave, sir. It's 12:55.
Yeah, yeah. I think, with the last word of Dinesh, all will leave. Okay. Let me hear from his mouth also. Dinesh, quickly, see, all your friends are wanted to leave class. Quickly, you should tell what is modulation. Dinesh Kumar. So I expect you to answer in the next class, okay? At least if not this class. Dinesh,
if you're yes, sir.
Difficulty, you should ask me questions, okay? So Monday, first hour is there, no? First question I will ask you about whatever I have discussed today, okay? Only if you answer, then okay. I will continue. I will go to the next topic. Okay, prepare and come, fine? Okay, then thank you all. You all can leave now.